Lou himself was certainly going through a heavy drug period during the whole time he was involved with Andy. There's no question about that. And there's also no question that Andy would have known about it. In fact, he wrote about it quite openly in some detail in Pompism, his memoir of the 60s. So, I mean, this scene was undoubtedly fueled by drugs. Oh, pardon me, sir. It's furthest from my mind. I'm just looking forward to different in my mind. A lot of the actors in the films, Flesh, Trash, Heat, Woman in Revolt, were on drugs all the time. Some of the people were on acid throughout the making of the movie. Every single scene was shot on acid. Some of them were on down. Some of them were smoking pot. Some of them were drinking. It was just an enormous amount. Andy himself was always very abstemious about drugs. He never actually took so-called illegal drugs. He took prescription drugs.
Are you saying that you are involved in this idea of making people more conscious of their lives, but you don't really want to get into their lives deeply? You just want to stir up.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Don't want to get too involved.
See, like Andy said when we did that cultural center thing, me and her, I said, if only the three of you could have worked together. I said, well, it wasn't my fault. I'll work with anybody. But you see, when we were working at the factory, they pitted us against each other. I mean, I knew what they were doing, but I wanted to do my job, and that's all. I don't like all this other bullshit.
Why would they pit you against each other?
To make it interesting.
I call myself Candy Warhol now. Cashing in.
Well, at first we were all friends, we were all girlfriends, because we were all out in, you know, the gutter together, so to speak. But then once stardom hit, especially with the two of them, Candy just went to that place. She just wanted stardom so desperately. And Jackie was sort of like, I at that point, I was like just the loose maniac. I just wanted to get laid and get high. You know, so I'm not making excuses for myself. I was having a good time, and I didn't give a shit about those two. I just wanted to have a fabulous time and be a model.
You know, these drag queens carry on and complain about all their problems and stuff. They don't really know what girls go through. I mean, they've never had a period.
But they take those pills.
I know, but they've never had a period. They can't really tell.
Said, I've come to hate my body and all that it requires in this world. Candy said,
me, Andy Warhol.
Candy went to Europe in 71 to do two films for the German director, Werner Schroeder. Andy felt that Candy should have breasts. Candy was basically a little flat-chested. She went to this doctor on Central Park West for estrogen shots. The shot was called the Black Pill because the pill was black. She got a lot of these shots and she continued going to this doctor. And that particular pill was taken off the market in 75 as being carcinogenic. So in a way, I'm sure that's what did her in. She had cancer of the blood. If you take female hormones, that changes the shape of the blood cell. And I really feel, though people didn't say it at the time, I really feel that was the beginning of the end for her.
And then I'm making a film called Premiere. It's the story of three women. An up-and-coming young star, an old and dying star, which is the one that I play. And I'm kept alive by a doctor just to go to this premiere. And I die. A Swiss doctor who shoots me up with monkey glands, female hormones. And what does Ultra take?
ever want to be pretty. I never want to be a fashion plate. That's my, I want to be a person to be reckoned with. You know, I want to really work. You know, I don't want to be just some beautiful thing.
Jackie Curtis continued to write plays. He was banished from the factory. Warhol had a new crowd of people up there who were like accountants. These were people who wore business suits. They were very elegant. They did not like Jackie Curtis dressed like a woman with a 3-day beard growth. They weren't ready for Jackie's amphetamine humor or his alcoholic binges or his demands for money. So Jackie, who had the name of Andy Warhol carved on his arm, a tattoo, left the factory.
Jackie became addicted to heroin and she died. She OD'd.
It's my wife and it's my life because a mana to my vein needs to a center in my head and then I'm better off in
shit. We'll just do what we always did, that's all.
I saw some nice garbage up on 24th Street.
How do you know that? I'm Andy Warhol.
The end of the Warhol era came for me basically because of a deal that was made that I was unhappy with. Paul would say things like to other people that were interested in working with me I don't really think he could do a script. And Andy would tell people, I thought he was a drug addict, you know. So, I mean, pretty much they weren't helping the further of my career in any way. I mean, I'd probably work with them the rest of my life if it was left to them. I don't know if I'll ever become a household name here in America, but my big thing is to land that television series that goes 50 episodes and, you know, you sit at home and collect the checks. That's pretty much my dream.
I'm going to fashion design school to be a... Actually, I'm studying... I want to become a costume designer. And... what else? Because I want to open up a little shop, a little haute couture shop, you know. Holly's, or whatever. What is it? Holly of Hollywood. You're sitting in the middle of nowhere, you know, from nowhere. Just like boom, 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 and I'm... strangest places. I mean, my parents heard it in Florida, and the fact that it's a classic, and it's just makes my panties twitter.
Holly came from Miami, FLA.
hitchhiked her way across USA. Plucked her eyebrows on the way, shaved her legs, and then he was a she. She says, hey, babe, take a walk on the wild side. Said, hey, honey, take a walk on the wild side.